Okay, so welcome back everybody. For me, this is the start of a new week, a new batch of videos, so I don't always say welcome back, because I don't always know where I'm going to sort of do the edits of each video. Okay, so what I'm going to do, let's just explain some things first, what I've done. Well, I cloned the install of this game, and I've checked Opal Decay. It does turn out exactly what I suspected. It was the procedural avionics packages, which are not compatible with Opal Decay's station keeping mode. But it's fine, it's easily fixed. You just have to put a probe core on top, or just not use the procedural probe core if you want a satellite to hold orbital position, as in station keeping, as I said. So that's working fine. Okay, and because I've been launching at night, it's been rather sort of not really much to watch as far as when I launch at night. It's just a black screen basically. So what I've done is I've installed another modification, which I did mention before, and apparently it wasn't actually working properly with real fuels, and it's called Engine Light. I've checked that as well and it's working fine, so there's a bit more to see now at night. There's a nice flare from the exhaust plumes of the rocket engines. Okay, and another thing as well, I'm going to go back to Vandenberg's VAB. I'm going to cancel the build. I can't do that here, obviously. I can't actually do that here, because this is for Kennedy's build list. So I'm going to go to VAB in Vandenberg, and I'm going to install. I've noticed basically the first stage of the Thor Agena package, the vehicle, has a very high thruster weight ratio. What I'm going to do, I'm going to see if I can insert an extra stage in between the Agena and the Thor. So that's an extra stage. It'll be a three stage launcher. I won't bother with this because the polar, it seems to be okay at reaching orbit with anything pretty light, but when it comes to something like the Corona 13, which is what we can see here. That's not here though. That's at Vandenberg. But you can't actually cancel it here because it's not being built here. So I'm going to go to Vandenberg and cancel the build, like I said. Okay, so I'm going to head into Vandenberg. I'm going to the tracking station first and then go to Vandenberg. So I won't bother you with the tracking station section. I'm only going to Vandenberg, so next time you see this, I'll be in the VAB. So go to the VAB in Vandenberg. Okay, so what I've decided to do, I decided to enable these interstage decouplers, even though I haven't really actually tested them properly, as in auto decouple. So what I've done, enable the bottom DC staging, so I don't need this decoupler. But I'd rather have the decoupler because I can decouple it then at my choice, my discretion. I can then engage these four SRBs on the interstage decoupler plate. The other stage beneath it, I'm not going to do that. So I've enabled the exact same way the top decoupler is going to stay, the top Ulich stage is going to work. Auto decoupler is on. Now what should happen, you disable that with your that is enabled. So this bottom DC staging, decoupled staging, should work on the first space bar. The second space bar should ignite these SRBs. Once these are finished, exhausted, it should automatically decouple from the top node. If you disable this and enable the top DC staging, you should do it opposite way around. That's the theory. But I've never actually tested them in flight. Bit silly, I know, probably, but I'm getting a bit fed up of pretending all the time on the VAB with this thing. I've been here for ages. So they're both configured about the same for their relative mass that they're pushing. So they're about 1.15, 1.18 in TWR. Now this stage has gone down slightly to 57 seconds because I've used a slightly lighter booster. It's the booster variant of the LR-79, which is LR-89 I'm using here. This is the booster version. It's about 300 kilos lighter as well. It is exactly the same power level though, but it's slightly lighter, which is a bit strange. Imagine 31 kilonewtons in a vacuum. That's a vacuum. They only have 79 here. If I can get that. It's 850, so it's slightly less powerful. But it's a lot heavier. It's about 300 kilos heavier, like 980 kilos just there. Okay, I'm going to clamp this up and then get it built and roll it out. So we'll go. Well, I'll clamp it up and I'll be out into the Space Center overview. Okay, so back outside. This is still Vandenberg. And I'll finish it up when it starts to build. I'm going to rush build it. I want to do a night launch. Because I've made everybody, all of you, sit through all that with me wittering on about things not working. I will show you engine lighting, which is the mod that I added. Makes it a little bit more realistic as far as it's not too much. I've still got 5.5 million, so like I'm gonna suddenly go bankrupt. And I have got the ionization launcher coming up, so that will be probably the next, either with the telecoms satellite, which I've begun to rebuild. It's actually another version which I showed you earlier on. I'm not using procedural avionics for its probe car, I'm using a standard probe car. Right, it's 3 days, 3 hours, 28 minutes and 50 odd seconds. Space plane hangar will be finished here. Oh no, it's KSC, never mind. Moving forward. It should actually upgrade this one as well, like I said. It seems to, for some reason, it drags everything over. Except the launch pad, for some reason. There we go. Yeah, for some reason, all the facilities except the launch pad, if you upgrade them at KSC, they upgrade them at all the other alternate sites. For some reason, I don't know. It's probably purely gameplay, because you can't start spending like 500,000 here and 500,000 there and 2 million here. And that's 4 million now. You can't do that every single launch site. What the devil happened there? Right. So I've got a day to finish. As I said, I'll either be the comms package that I launch from Kennedy next launch video, or the ionization experiment that I launch for the first time. Let's roll this out. It's gonna be 14 hours. That's all right. It's almost, mate. It's middle of summer, so. And get quite. So which one's this? I hope it's this one. I hope it's this. Yeah, VAB Vandenberg. So not the other one to finish yet. So I rush build this. Get a constellation. It's still 13. So it will be the comms package I launch next. Then the one after that will be the ionization experiment. So 254 GMT. So it's about 2100 hours. So I'm gonna go till it gets dark. Here we are. Not too stupidly dark. It's actually quite nicely lit because there's a town just up there, which is a bit weird. That's possibly the airbase, I hope. I'm gonna sort of crash land on someone's head. Anyway. Let's head to the launch pad and. Yeah, it was being a night launch, like I said. I fitted some floodlights to the clamps again. But engine light should work. I've checked it before, so it should work. So let's head to the launch pad. Okay, I found a bait. Launch site. Yeah, it's not exactly pitch black because we've got some of these bright textures over here. The bottom of the rock is down here, so the bottom of the launcher is there. So I may need some more sort of clamp, something like that, just so I can add some more lights on. Because they're not fantastically bright. Okay, right. Let's just on full throttle. Don't need to bother about where the horizon is, at least. Unlock that. This on heading is 180. So I'm going to try going polar. Roll is 180, just so it doesn't roll. It's already in that position. It's already in that attitude, so it's rolled towards the camera. Alright, so I'm going to go 85 degrees at about 1 kilometre, between 1 and 2, about 2.5 kilometres. Actually, 85 degrees at 2.5 kilometres, 2,500 metres. Now go to 80 degrees at about 5 kilometres, 5,000 metres. And I'll leave 80 degrees up until about 20 kilometres. And I'm going to start going over about 5 degrees every 10 kilometres after that. Until I reach sort of the upper area of the atmosphere, and I'll push it over even further, a little bit more rapidly. Alright, this is the first launch of a vertical three stage stack, and it's also the first time I'm going to launch at night with engine lighting. So okay, so 3, 2, 1. vernies aren't actually working. Let's take a look at those. So now I've got no roll control. I can see two verniers there on the first stage cluster, but I don't know what the extra one is. It's only two. There's supposed to be two fitted. It's a bit weird. I'm also rolling off prograde again. But you know I'm not. So I'm going to switch to just a standard SAS and let it take itself. It's because it's, I think it's because it's nose heavy. Which I suppose it would be. Okay. I'm going to leave that up though, just in case. Rather high though. Rather close to vertical. So look in the map, might get a little bit noisy. Stage the couple and hopefully it might ignite at the same time, but there we go, I thought it would. And I have no idea what happened just then. It's actually decoupling at the wrong time. Well, that was a spectacular failure. My god. So, it's actually decoupling at the wrong time. It's decoupling too early. That's the exact problem I had before with it. And the only way to solve it is to actually... My god. The only way to actually solve it is by taking up action menu points. As in, functions. You've only got so many to use before you actually run out. But that's why action menu extended is for, I suppose. My god, what a waste. Yep, that's exactly the problem I've been having with those interstage decouplers. The decouple for some reason at the top before I actually finished giving you eulage, so they push themselves right through the stage above it and destroy it. Okay, so after I got that back, after I recovered it from the ocean, I got 5 extra science points. So that means it wasn't such a wasted sort of amount of time. Okay, I'm gonna head into the VAB. It's gonna take 12 hours to repair anyway, to sort of refurbish the launch pad. So I headed back into the VAB and I'm going to put the decouplers where I said I was. I'm going to turn auto decoupling off those interstage decoupling eulage stroke sort of eulage plates. Okay, so back in the VAB. Now, as I said, I'm going to leave this decoupling in place because I want to decouple this before I ignite the stage, this unit stage. But that's basically it. So there's a decoupler here. I've turned auto decoupling off. What I need to do is so. What on earth is that doing up? Yeah, the fairing shouldn't be all the way up there though, should it? How's the fairing get all the way up there? That's weird. Take 30 days though. Just for the extra decoupler, it's going to take an extra 7 days. It's a bit steep, isn't it? Well, I don't want those anywhere near there. I'm not really interested. So I'm going to put that there. So that's actually into stage itself. Decoupler is just there. Which is after this ignites. I just need this down here. I want it sometime sort of after this second stage ignites. So that. Then decoupler at the bottom. Then I choose when to ignite it. Right, so. That's the staging sorted. So something tells me it's something to do with this decoupler. Like I said, it's missing turbotin these interstage decouplers anywhere. With the ewelage. It's counting the ewelage. But it's not actually counting the loss of the mass beneath it. Not fully. Right, let's try again. 31 days. So we'll try this corona. I'm going to put this on to build. I'm going to head back to Kennedy. For the next launch. Okay, so as you saw, it's not quite as easy as it should be to use those interstage decouplers. Oh, Constellation A. To sync just 2 stages. So I don't particularly I'm not too impressed with this with the insertion of an extra stage on the Thortogena. Not impressive at all. Although you know, like I said, it is entirely possible that cable engineering ducts in the VAB there could actually be not telling the truth. That's entirely possible. In fact, it looks as if that's exactly what he's going on. He's not telling the truth. I'll do these 2 launches back to back. Okay, so it's Constellation A. Then as soon as the science satellite A is finished, I'll launch that. Then we'll go back to Vandenberg for a future episode. Okay, so let's go to launch pad. Okay, so back at the launch pad. Full throttle is on, SS is on. So this needs to be at 35 degrees below the equator, the equatorial line. So that's 90, which is 0. We've got 35 on, it's 125. I'm going to go slightly lower than that, 127 or so. So it brings us up. Of course, we're not exactly on the equator. We're actually probably pointing well beneath it, so it might be more than the 35 degrees. Shouldn't be much more though. Maybe 40 something degrees. But if it's below that particular line, we should be fine. We can always sort of modify it. So I'm going to bring this up and pop this here. So I'm going to pick that up there. Just so I can keep an eye on. I need to actually achieve. So right now inclination is 28.8. So inclination is 28.8 degrees. So we don't need anything like that amount. We need 7 degrees, isn't it? 7 degrees also. So if we go to 100, that should give us plenty. on top of that gives an extra 10 degrees. So it gives about 38 degrees, or 38 or 39 degrees or so. We should be fine. Right, so same as before, roll program, heading obviously, then I'll pitch over about between 1 and 2 kilometres to 85 degrees, then between 3 and 5 kilometres down to 80 degrees, then hold it to about 15-20 kilometres and go over to 75, then 70 and then so forth. So on and so forth. Okay, so this is Constellation Air. This is the first of the. So I'm just going to push the apoapsis as high as this thing will actually take it. But I need to get to 4,000. Might be such a good idea to put that there. 4,500, and at the lowest point, so it's at least 4,500 and at least 850 kilometres at the apoapsis and the periapsis, respectively. Oh, I need to get up there first. Alright, so here we go. I do need to put some floodlights on the clamps as well, but I'm pretty sure I did that before, but never mind. Okay, so 3, 2, one. don't have enough inclination. Yeah, I should have. It might be because I'm just not. Yeah. I'm going to change the inclination a little bit more. I'm at 125. Can't be thinking right now, obviously. Speed up on the first stage. Although I forgot what that was. I keep doing that. I keep forgetting to actually decouple. Never mind. Let's decouple and then get some yardage. Okay, so 3, 2, 1. This stage, circularise the orbit first, turn off, then get to the next, get to the periapsis, then reignite the Agena stage and use the blast of the fuel to get to about 4,500 kilometres. It's the best I can do for now. That's given us a 35.2, almost 35.3 degrees inclination, so that's fine. That's ticked. I've got enough fuel for a second burn. I'm not going to do it apoapsis, I'm going to do it at the periapsis. So I'm going to take the motor off, so it gives us an orbit apoapsis 223.74 kilometres. And a periapsis of 207.129. That's going up slightly. Which it will do. Alright. That's it though. I'll continue to burn using this because I'm going to carry on pushing. I don't want to sort of push at the prograde marker and then see by the time I finish the second burn, realise I'm not at the actual inclination I want to be, just in case. Now I could burn at the apoapsis, but I'm not going to. I'm going to burn at the periapsis to push the apoapsis up. It might be more efficient that way. So I'm going to leave this where it is because there's no reason not to. Alright. I'm going to wipe this off. I'm just going to warp forward. I think I need this anymore. I'll just tuck it up there just a little bit further because I know where I need to be. 4,500 kilometres at the apoapsis at least. And 850. I can only push one or the other. So it might be okay to burn the apoapsis because I need to push the periapsis up quite a lot as well. Yeah, that's fine. Periapsis and apoapsis will swap places anyway. And this motor does have a rather short lifespan, as far as the MTBF is concerned. And again, obviously I've got the, because one of the things for ionization scan satellite is to reach orbit, so I've got the reward for that. Can't complete it because obviously I don't have the equipment on board. That's for the next flight. Right, so I'm going to leave this as it is. No reason not to. I can get Eulidge. Did I disable them or did I not? Let's just take a quick look. Ah, got the moon there. Can't see a damn thing there. There's a motor. No, that's fine. Of course, it's rotating the craft around. That's fine, I can deal with the hydrazine working this anyway. Not until I'm sort of ready. Shut down the engine and put full throttle on until that says stable, but not quite yet. So I've got about 2 minutes to apoapsis. This will run for 4 minutes, so I'm going to engage at 2 minutes to the apoapsis. Get some Eulidge. Okay, the Eulidge in 3, 2, 1. Very risky, very stable, ignition, now. Perfect. 4,500, went well over. Which is fine. Just let the stage burn out. I can't ignite it again, so it's minimum. And the higher the apoapsis, the easier it is to move the periapsis up. And again, we're only at 34%, 34 degrees inclination. What the heck's going on? What's going on with inclination? Well, I want to try and correct that. That's weird. I mean, I didn't touch the inclination at all. But it's increasing slightly where we are. Which way would it go? Problematic. So I think the best thing to do is just to stay at well over the inclination. That's weird. No, I don't get that at all. So if I point directly towards 180, it's absolutely cracking. I'm gonna whistle my RCS though. I need to figure this part out because this is just not making much sense. I suppose you really point anti-norm, which is like that. Which is what this is. I'm trying where I am. It says it's going to be greater than. I shouldn't need to mess around that much. That's only telling me how pushing the apoapsis up even higher. It's at 14,000.6 kilometers now. It qualifies as being at greater than 4,500 kilometers, that is, 4,500 meters. No, 4,500 kilometers. Put my teeth in. So, top access is 2 hours. Yeah, I think I might as well do this at the apoapsis and push the periapsis while I'm doing this, because I'm just wasting RCS fuel. But of course, from the periapsis, it'll be upwards. Not upwards, it'll be normal as opposed to anti-normal. Well, we can check that. Just the immediate sort of comms lines that I'm actually using right now. So another 1 hour. 5 minutes either side, so I'm going to just check. So 35.91574 degrees. Yeah, I think we need to so it needs to be the other way. We need to point towards the north. Come on. Don't waste it all. Exactly at normal or anti-normal, because I want to also push the axis up slightly as well, or slightly about the other 500 kilometers. I don't know why it does that. It really does waste your RCS though. Right, stop pushing forward. See if that. Yeah, that's fine. So I can correct the inclination as I'm bringing up the periapsis. That's it, about 4, maybe 5 minutes either side of the node again and then stop. So I should just wasting fuel. It's going up quite nicely there, and the periapsis is definitely going up nicely. So that should be normal. Degrees. Up to 35 degrees. If I bring this back to point at the prograde marker, let it go to about 30. But what we're doing now. Still got the spacecraft itself, it can probably modify its own inclination. Yeah, so it's actually just slightly coming down. Looks like going back up again, that's fine. Is it bouncing on the on the node? So 80 to 81. Not 260, sorry. 265. 2 minutes to the node. Took it some 30 seconds or so. Beep. And you see the closer you get to the actual node itself, the actual apogee, apoapsis, or the periapsis and perigee. So it affects the alternate or the opposite node more the closer you get to the its parent node. Sorry, not its parent node, it's all. Its opposite node. Yeah, this launcher is very capable when it comes to light packages at equatorial orbit, or not just not far off the equatorial, but when it comes to actual polar, we need that second stage. So I'll make it a three stage. Seconds or so. Don't really need to be on this map view anymore. Like I said, this comms satellite has a normal probe, there's a procedural part in there. So, well, it's capable of holding its station keeping. Up to 30 seconds of the mod. Carry on beyond the node itself for about 2, maybe 3 minutes. Okay, as I was saying, next engine, previous engine, you can actually select different engines, different types of fuel. And this is station keeping, so you can turn station keeping on and off with this note, with this probe core. And the procedural ones, like I said earlier, you can't do that. So it's not such a big deal, because most satellites you don't need to have to station keeping. It's not absolutely necessary. To about another couple of minutes, then stop. So I'm about 400, so I'll stop at 425 kilometers, so I'm doing halfway. No, well, I'll stop at 500 kilometers. Should just be able to make it to 500. Next couple of minutes. So about 2 minutes and 30 seconds intermission. It's 2 hours and 27 minutes actually. It's 2 hours, and, so I'll go 2 hours 30 minutes. So, when that reads 30, I'm going to stop and wait for it to go back out to this position again. Then carry on. Okay. A little bit late. It's about 3 minutes too, but it should be fine. Okay, so hopefully this should take you up to 850 kilometres. That's the last thing to actually get. Some inclination. That perhaps is orbit, obviously. So that's all that's left. Well, the fuel I've got could take about 900 kilometres easy. Here's what I think I'll do. I'll give it 50 kilometres clear. Kilometres. Ten kilometres. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. This won't provide anything else that fails. I'll disable the glow on that for starters. In dying, I thought I already had, but never mind. So which way do I need to actually rotate? I believe it should be nose up. Let's take that off. Nope, she's all right. It should be about there. Is that about it? I think that's close enough. Right. So I begin the rotation. I use a Genus stage rather than wasting a fuel here. Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Okay, so click control from here. Alright, so decouple. 3, 2, 1. Believe. Alright, so what's wrong now? Oh, it's fine. I've got to lock the tank. Yeah. I've already activated these RCS. I have. Yeah. But I should be able to press a key. I'm doing it now. I'm going to press 0. Oh, never mind. Are they all enabled now? Yep. That's okay. No, there was only two of them enabled. The devil. No, oh, good grief. I knew I should have enabled them. Oh, never mind. I should have hot stage, not hot stage, I knew I should have action menued them. Yeah, the loss of all that mass, you can see how quickly Perry House is going up. Just one half a second burst and it's going up by 4 kilometer. And that's only this tank. spin again. It still uses electric charge though. See what happens if I walk forward. Yeah, so it's the avionics package. I don't need the avionics package live all the time. I can shut that down. Alright, so I'm getting electric charge 0.01, but that's enough. Enable station keeping. You can do that anywhere. But I won't do that just yet. Okay, so that's that. Got 58.65. It's a tiny, tiny amount. With this sort of orbit, you've used very little fuel for station keeping anywhere. So that's 14,647.3 kilometres by 912.116.1 kilometres. For 27 minutes and 207 minutes. Glacier is just above 35 degrees. That's it. Okay, so first communication satellite. Congratulations, satellite communication will be how humans communicate across the globe with each other. Completion rewards 30,000 plus 5 reputation, but no science. Do we have any? No. Didn't think so. But... okay, so that's it. So we now have 5.617839 million and 10.1 signs. I have no idea how much reputation we've got. It's well into the green area. Alright, so next up is the science launch, the actual ionization satellite. Which is a contract for a private company, if I can tell. Okay, let's head back to the Space Center.